Good afternoon, everyone. It doesn't matter if you're a Mac or Windows user, most of us having the same problem in some cases, the storage capacity. For example, tasks like video editing. And especially Mac users are facing this problem frequently, as the best-seller MacBook is the Air version with 250GB of SSD capacity. Because we don't want to pay huge amounts just for upgrading to 512GB of capacity. So, what options do we have to get more storage without losing too much read and write speed? The answer is an SSD enclosure. Usually, an SSD enclosure which can support external M2 NVMe SSDs up to 2TB. It has USB 3.1 Gen 2 with transfer rate up to 10 gigabits per second. Believe me, I have read more than 300 reviews on multiple online websites such as Amazon, AliExpress, and Banggood. Anyway, at the end, just made up my decision to get the Ugreen one from Amazon. And in this video, we are going to make speed tests by using Blackmagic Disk Speed Tester for Mac, Crystal Disk Speed Tester for Windows, writing from computer to SSD enclosure, and writing from SSD enclosure to computer on two different laptops. The first one is the MacBook Air M1 base version, and the second one is Asus ROG Strix G17 Gaming Beast. Okay, first I would like to show you what we get in the box. The SSD enclosure itself. The body is made full of aluminum, which is a must to keep the SSD cool. And this temperature issue is actually a topic for another video that I am going to try to explain you how to keep your external SSD cooler to not to lose performance while video rendering and gaming. A spare holder to keep the SSD in place, and a QuietFeel 10 gigabits per second USB-C data cable. Of course, we need an M2 NVMe SSD to fit into enclosures. And I am going to use this Samsung 980 NVMe SSD, which is a great price and performance product. I have already made a detailed test and review video for this SSD, and you can find the video link in the description. By the way, as it says, the max speed of the SSD, 3500 megabytes per second on the box, that is the maximum speed you can get when you install it on your motherboard. On the other hand, the maximum speed you can get while using the Ugreen enclosure is around 1000 megabytes, as the max speed of enclosure is 10 gigabits per second. Okay, how to install your SSD into enclosures? First, open the cover and hold your SSD like I do in the video. There is a very important point that you need to pay attention to not to damage your SSD while installing. You need to insert your SSD with an angle between 40 and 45 degrees like this, and apply some strong pressure to hear the click sound. If you try to insert with 0 degree angle, it won't slide in, and it is a big risk to damage your SSD. After that, stabilize it with this included tiny soft plastic holder, close it, and insert USB-C data cable. It's time. First, we are testing it on MacBook Air. Before we can use it on Apple devices, we should format it with the APFS file system. To do it, we should open the Disk Utilities menu. Choose our external drive. Click Erase, choose APFS format, and click Erase. It is done. Now let's open Blackmagic Disk Speed Test. By the way, the screen recording is also functional at the moment. Time to see how fast it is on Mac system. Yes, write speed is 805 megabytes per second and read speed is 810 megabytes per second. Now on Windows with Crystal Disk. The screen recording is on and the SSD is also formatted back to NTFS. As we can see, it is faster about 150 megabytes per second on Windows. How is the data transfer speed on Mac? A 9.27 GB file from computer to enclosure. Same file from enclosure to computer. The data transfer speed is actually quite fast. On Windows, a 5.56 GB file from computer to enclosure. Same file from enclosure to computer. Here, I am not sure, but MacBook data transfer speed looks like faster. While Windows resulted faster on this speed test, I am not sure because Mac does not let you know the transfer speed in megabytes but seconds. In my opinion, this feature is a plus for Windows. Also consider file different sizes, and you are right, why I did not use the same file for running this test? Seriously, I just realized it now. Overall, using an external SSD is the most affordable way to enlarge your SSD storage size. And I am very happy with this Ugreen enclosure and Samsung 908 SSD combination. Especially every Mac user who's stuck with 250 GB of storage on board should consider this setup. Okay, if you would like to get these items, you may find the links in the video description. Please don't forget to support me by subscribing, leaving comment, and by hitting that like button if you find this video helpful. As always, thank you for watching and have a great day.